U.S. states with the weirdest taxes. U.S. states with the weirdest taxes.
Taxes in America, part three. First up is New Hampshire with its dirt tax. In the Granite State, there's a tax on the excavation of sand, gravel, and other earth materials. If you move more than 1,000 cubic yards, you have to pay a tax of 2 cents per cubic yard. Next is Virginia, where there's a sheep tax. Virginia imposes a 50-cent excise tax on every sheep or lamb sold within the state. Then we have North Carolina with its pet tax. In some counties, owners are required to pay an annual tax of up to $30 for each pet they own. In Minnesota, clothing that consists primarily of fur is subject to a 6.5% tax. This is applied at the time of purchase, also taxing charges like shipping and handling. And these states tax illegal drugs. North Carolina, Kansas, Alabama, Georgia, Tennessee, Massachusetts, Nebraska, and Nevada all require dealers to purchase tax stamps and place them on the packaging of their products. These states have the highest property taxes. Wisconsin and Texas share very similar rates, 1.65% to 1.85% in Wisconsin to fund K-12 education and local government services, and 1.62% to 1.83% in Texas. Despite being a red state, property taxes are high in Texas to make up for a lack of state income tax and to fund public services needed for its fast-growing population. Vermont comes in at number 5, 1.71% to 1.98%. The state's rural nature means that fewer businesses contribute to the tax base, putting more burden on homeowners. Connecticut ranges from 1.79% to 2.02%. The state's wealthier towns often have higher property values and tax rates. Next, New Hampshire. In Illinois, the effective property tax rate is 2.05% to 2.27%. The state faces ongoing budget challenges and significant pension obligations. Lastly, New Jersey, with the highest rate of 2.21% to 2.49%, the state has many local governments and school districts, each with its own taxing authority. That, along with high property values, contribute to these high rates. These states have the highest property taxes. Wisconsin and Texas share very similar rates, 1.65% to 1.85% in Wisconsin to fund K-12 education and local government services, and 1.62% to 1.83% in Texas. Despite being a red state, property taxes are high in Texas to make up for a lack of state income tax and to fund public services needed for its fast-growing population. Vermont comes in at number 5, 1.71% to 1.98%. The state's rural nature means that fewer businesses contribute to the tax base, putting more burden on homeowners. Connecticut ranges from 1.79% to 2.02%. The state's wealthier towns often have higher property values and tax rates. Next, New Hampshire. In Illinois, the effective property tax rate is 2.05% to 2.27%. The state faces ongoing budget challenges and significant pension obligations. Lastly, New Jersey, with the highest rate of 2.21% to 2.49%, the state has many local governments and school districts, each with its own taxing authority. That, along with high property values, contribute to these high rates. These states have the highest property in America. These sin taxes are in place to discourage harmful behaviors and generate revenue. First up, Kentucky, which has the highest tax on wine at $3.13 per gallon, supporting public health and social programs. Next, we have West Virginia with its fireworks tax. This excise tax of 12% is aimed at the sale of consumer fireworks and is intended to fund safety and education programs. Then there's Texas with its adult entertainment tax. This 5% tax, often referred to as the poll tax, is applied to the gross receipts from admissions, drinks, and other sales at adult entertainment venues, generating revenue while addressing the social costs associated with these businesses. In Chicago, Illinois, there's a tax on bottled water, 5 extra cents per bottle, aiming to reduce plastic waste and encourage tap water consumption. Finally, Connecticut, New York, and Washington, D.C. have the highest sin taxes on cigarettes, $5.01 per pack in D.C., and $4.35 per pack in New York and Connecticut. In America, these sin taxes are in place to discourage more of of the weirdest taxes in America. First up is Kentucky, with its stud fee horse tax. Kentucky imposes a 6% sales tax on the fees paid for breeding stallions. In Virginia, registering a vehicle comes with a 4.15% sales and use tax, even if you purchase the vehicle out of state. Also, vehicles kept in the state for 30 or more days are taxed as local property. Next is Maryland's flush tax. Maryland charges residents $5 per month on sewer bills and an annual fee of $60 for septic systems. Then we have Pennsylvania with its alcohol tax. Originally introduced to help rebuild the city of Johnstown after a devastating flood in 1936, this 18% tax on alcohol is still in effect today. Next up is Nevada with its gaming tax. As the home of Las Vegas, Nevada imposes taxes on casinos and gaming revenue. And in Florida, hospitality and tourism spots like resorts, hotels, and cruises charge extra mandatory fees. The final total, including these fees, is subject to the transient rental tax and the tourist development tax. Depending on the county, the transient rental tax is between 6% to 7%, and the tourist development tax is between 1% to 5%. More of the weirdest taxes in America. These states cut the most taxes in 2024. First up is Iowa, which brought its top individual income tax rate down from 6% to 5.7%. Iowa is also on its way to a flat tax system where everyone pays the same rate no matter how much they earn, aiming for a rate of 3.9% by 2026. Georgia lowered its flat individual income tax rate from 5.75% to 5.39%. Kentucky made a significant cut by reducing its flat individual income tax rate from 4.5% to 4.0%. And in Nebraska, the state reduced its top individual income tax rate from 6.84% to 5.84%, and its corporate tax rate from 7.25% to 5.84%. Additionally, Nebraska eliminated its community college property tax, no longer taxing property by an extra 5.5% to fund community colleges. Finally, Connecticut tops the list. The state reduced individual income tax rates for the two lowest brackets from 3% to 2%. And from 5% to 4.5%. Additionally, Connecticut increased the amount of money they add to the earned income tax credit for low-income families in the state. They now match the credit by 40%. These are the weirdest taxes in America. First up is Maine with its blueberry tax. Maine is the largest producer of blueberries in the U.S., and every pound of wild blueberries is subject to a tax of 1.5 cents. Next is California, where there's a tax on fruit bought from vending machines. While buying fruit at a grocery store is tax-free, getting the same fruit from a vending machine costs you an extra 33% in taxes. Then we have Arkansas, which has a body art tax, costing an extra 6% to get tattoos, body piercings, and electrolysis. Next up is New York, where sliced bagels are taxed an extra 8 cents, despite whole bagels being tax-free, as they are classified as grocery items. But as soon as it's sliced or prepared with cream cheese, the bagel becomes a prepared food item, and the tax is applied. In Kansas, hot air balloons are subject to the amusement tax, which adds an extra 6.5% to your ride. But if it's not tethered, it's considered transportation, and it's tax-free. And in Alabama, there's a tax on playing cards. If you buy a deck of playing cards with 54 or fewer cards, you'll end up paying a 10 cent tax per pack. Also, in Texas, belt buckles are subject to taxation unless you cowboy up on a sales tax holiday and buy a matching belt and maybe even a pair of boots to go with it. Then it's tax-free. Finally, there's Colorado, where coffee cup lids are taxed. While the coffee itself might not be taxed, the lid that comes with it is considered non-essential packaging and is subject to a 2.9% tax.